Okay, so I run soldering classes and blinky building sessions, and we've been making do with little Radio Shack soldering stations, and they're kind of garbage, and they're starting to fall apart. So I figured I'd start investigating some of these real inexpensive knockoff. Hacko knockoff stations. So I picked this thing up off of eBay this week for $30. I actually picked up a couple of them. And I'm gonna do a little quick teardown on them. I'm not doing an unboxing because I hate unboxings. Anyway, it came, it's ready to go. For some reason, I don't know, even the Hacko that I bought didn't come with one of these, but it came with a spare heating element. Came with a bunch of tips and came with, I don't know, a few ounces of 0.6 millimeter. This is leaded solder. It's 37, whatever it is. It's not 60, it's that stuff close to 60/40 stuff. It's real hard to read. 63/37. And this unit here, first I'm going to turn it on. Play around with it a little bit, then I'll tear it down, see what's inside. Okay, so this little came in this vinyl bag here. It's a pretty nice, relatively thick vinyl bag. It wasn't just a cheap poly bag. The tips in general are, I mean, they're not horrible. There's a really, it came with a super fine tip on installed, and it's got a couple of different conical tips, which I don't really like conical tips, but whatever. Came with a big fat whatever that is, not a chisel tip really. It came with this is basically a chisel tip, although it's really only chiseled on one side. And then it's got this half conical or whatever that is. These are actually pretty useful. Assuming that this is already tinned, usually inside of there's a big cup there and it holds a lot of solder, so it's really nice for drag soldering. The instruction manual here is it's a cheap Xerox manual, but it's actually doesn't really have any Chinglish in it to speak of. Seemed okay to me. Here's the unit here. Nothing horrible on the outside of it that I can see. Turn the thing on, and it's pretty nice. You can do your set point here. So to 200 up to 480, and let's just set it at 3, whatever. And after you leave it alone for a second, it goes down to actual temperature. And it does have a sense on the soldering iron. I'm not going to leave that on because I want to take it apart. But it does go up to temperature and then hold there, whatever your set point is. Okay, just going to tear the tip down. It's pretty much cooled off. Just to show what's in there. This is completely standard Hacko stuff here. Tips a little warm yet. It's over the top of a ceramic heating element there. We unscrew this bit, and that's just the metal piece here unscrewing. It's not twisting the ceramic bit. You pull that off, and there's your ESD grounding. You push this up from the bottom, and there's, you can see where the new heating element can be soldered in place. So we've got five wires. We've got the two heating wires. We've got the two sense wires, and we've got the ESD grounding here. So when this goes back in again, you've got to rotate that to get it. It's got some tabs that it fits down into to keep it from getting twisted when you remove the end there. Let's put this back together again. put a different tip on it because I don't like that. Oops. That's one thing. These tips are kind of garbage. I mean, especially this one here is messed up. Unfortunately, the one that I actually like to use. Most of them are actually fine. This one's all shiny and everything. I think most of them are fine. But of course, the one that I want to use, I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's all rusty and bubbly. Let's see if I can. Not really. It looks like they might have dipped it into tinning bath or something and dropped this one in or something. I don't know. It's pretty horrible. So, I don't know. This tip may be a loss. Anyway, whatever. 30 bucks. What can you say? Yeah. Actually, with very little encouragement, just a little bit tiny 10 seconds of shaving with a pocket knife, that tip went in there just fine. It's still ugly, but it did go on. Okay, let's take the main unit apart. The head off. That's a totally standard Hecko type connector there. Okay, crack the sucker open, see what's inside. Alright, looks pretty clean in general. Well, there's a fuse, looks like. Yep, there's a little fuse there. So I guess that's one reason you might have to open it up. Although I can't imagine that it would normally blow. Let's see, all of the connectors here are heat shrunk. This is grounding straps. It looks like it's made almost out of tin foil, but what the heck, it's there. It's soldered, I believe best practices would be for that to be crimped, not soldered, but it's not horrible. The transformer doesn't look too bad. Let's see if I can get some better shots of this. Transformer doesn't look horrible. That's not ideal, but that's okay. This thing here is wobbling around in the wind. That 20220. The heat sink isn't secured at all, it doesn't look like. It looks like it's just wobbling around. Maybe it is. No, it's just. Oh. No, it's just hanging there. It looks like it. I don't know, there's some red stuff there, like they tried to glue it down, but it didn't. It wasn't actually stuck. Okay, I'll get that. This just sticks in there like that. The soldering's not atrocious. There's a little bit of flux residue on the board, but it's not horrible. So there's two secondaries. It says AC. What do we got here? 10.5 volts, and this is probably higher for the tip. Yeah, AC 26 volts. So this is probably for the control electronics, and this is the drive current through that MOSFET there. I'm going to take the front panel off here. Okay, I can't take the front panel off without unsoldering this, and I'm not going to do that. You can kind of see down inside of there. The component placement is a bit haphazard. There's components, CO220 is just hanging, flopping in the wind. things just bent over there. It's interesting that I see there is socketed. That's weird. Certainly a microcontroller there of some sort. Be interesting to see what that is, but I'm not that interested to tear the thing apart. Probably a pick or something. Anyway, I'm not too upset with this thing for $30. It seems like a hell of a value. It doesn't look to me like it's actually dangerous in any way. The longevity, you know, if you were, if this thing was going to be subject to a lot of vibration and stuff, I think this thing here would probably not last more than a few months, maybe a year or two, before it fractured one of those solder joints or the leads. But in all, you know, if this thing's sitting in a bench, it's probably going to be just fine. I'm going to try using it actually a little bit here and see how it goes. Okay, I just finished soldering together and doing a little tutorial on building one of my Blinkies. I used this new soldering iron, this $30 Hacko knockoff, and I was quite pleasantly surprised. The temperature control was spot on. It climbed up to 352, and it just stayed there the whole time. The thing had plenty of heat. I mean, there's not anything of a huge thermal mass on here, but it worked great. No problems. I think I'm going to buy a few more of these things.